Oh, yes, I'm going to change on the reimbursement for you. Correct.
Yes.
Yes.
Next, public business. We want to take a little bit of discussing the vacant building at Marcus Plaza.
Correct.
We are making any headways to actually eliminate the structure itself. We have the engineer here, and we are studying the feasibility of having this done actually this year. Because as you know, that building is really a town on our side in a sense, because not only it doesn't look appealing to our residents here in South Tom's River, but also we have complaints from neighboring municipalities like Tom's River and those who are going through our town, that it's definitely not a pretty sight. And so it's long overdue. We should at least discuss what we can do to eliminate that ugliness in the midst of South Tom's River. And so I just would like to open this for discussion.
I would recommend that you knock it down. We just drove by there again tonight to check it out, and all the paint that we had done last year is all off. It looks terrible. And that's the main entrance. And people from all over comment on how terrible it looks. The borough's never going to have funds to renovate it, you know that, the way things are.
Right.
You know what? Let's just knock it down and fix that area up. Don't forget where those gas pumps were. You've got those metal rods sticking up, and there's like a big platform, and that all has to come down also. So, council, gentlemen, ladies, it's in your hands now.
Yes, Steve.
First is doing this property, and so tearing stuff down, building on what happens on the strip, so they tear it down and help me knock it down. Second thing is that after the project, 4 or 5 years ago, we actually had sewage.
We had some discussions with the borough engineer last year about the ability to renovate or reconstruct that building that was demolished, and I don't know that we got a definite answer. My understanding was that once if we were to demolish that building, we likely would not be able to rebuild anything there. So we explored the possibility of, actually we did a couple of times, tried to get someone to bid on it. And we actually had one bid, and then the bidder thought better of it than the fall bid, and we ended up reaching a settlement where we kept part of the deposit. And then we looked into a long-term lease where someone would have a significant capital outlay to renovate the project in exchange for, I forget if it was 10 years or more, pay the borough rent to then run probably, like say, a luncheonette, coffee shop, snack stand type thing out of it. And we actually never... I don't think everyone out to bid on that. The idea was to have a pre-construction meeting, those things, but it turned out that the cost appeared just prohibitive for someone to do a rental, even a long-term rental. But my understanding was that trying to find if there's a way we could get some kind of letter of no interest or something from the DEP to say we could demolish it and then still rebuild it, and I don't think that was likely. So, but I knew we had run sewer out there. I didn't realize we had an issue with the CDBG money now. But what happens if we then, obviously, if we demolish the building, we can't rebuild it.
The sewer lines are still
there. Yeah, but if we demolish the building, you can't rebuild it. And we never use the sewer lines.
If you do rebuild it, you have to get a capital permit.
Yeah.
And
cost of that is prohibited to a town like this.
So you have to waive the ugliness of that building that's been laying there for how many years?
I agree with that, Paul, yes.
Compared to...
No, I'm sorry.
Are we ever gonna renovate it? Who's going to lease it the way it is? You can't have anybody walk in there.
Open so that we can lease it if something comes up.
Well, I think that's part of the problem, is we, nope, we even had an issue with, he might need a capital permit for someone to renovate it even. So no one's gonna come in here and rent something from us to pay with that limited square footage. It's not like it's a lot machine, where they, you know, they have that kind of, you know, right across the river, and I'm using that as an example, but it's not as if they have that kind of size, they're gonna make that kind of money without, would justify $200,000 in engineering and permitting fees and renovation, which is what it would take or something like that. So, do you think you can get us some kind of opinion, Mr. Theodos, on the, you know, the applicability of the CAFRA permit for that, and if we were to demolish it, what would the options be? And
well, my thinking is that
Do you need a CAFRA permit to renovate it? Right. That was the idea, we'd use the existing four walls, although it's admittedly pretty small.
But if you destroy it without building any structure on it, you don't need no CAFRA permit. You just eliminate that building.
Well, as Steve says, that area is required with Green Acre funds, so you might have an issue. You might need permission to even demolish it. Well, it seems like you would get it because it would be a benefit to demolish it.
Right.
Although the problem is, if you don't ask them, then they'll fine you for having not asked them. So
we just have to follow the procedure.
We have the engineer checking the feasibility of getting permission from Green Acres to demolish the building.
That part is in Green Acres, though, right, Ernie? That building's not on Green Acres. No, that building is not on Green Acres.
All right. Okay.
There was a portion that is not on Green Acres.
Go ahead, Ernie.
The problem with that building, right? No matter what you lease it to, suppose it's the amount of time you could build, whether it's Green Acres or whoever, there is no parking. You have to use massive size of the park.
Right, no doubt. Mm-hmm.
So if you had to go whatever route to knock it down, the best solution. The sewers cost about $160,000 when we put in, they went from there and they tied it on the Boone Road. So it's better to take a loss of that money and use that part of mattress plaza or whatever. It's better to lose something than to have an eyesore forever. If anybody ever was inside that building, which I think, you could shake inside it. One of those walls hadn't fell down already. That's how bad it is. And I had that with a fire marshal back in the 85 and 90 when the fire marshal Kedgerson was there. We've been in that building. That's how bad it is.
At the very least, it should be surrounded. If you say that if you touch one of the walls or part of the structure, it might fall or, you know, shape, then I think maybe a liability that
should be fenced.
You have the insurance representative in here telling us that do not allow anyone inside that building. That's how bad it is.
That's why he took
he went inside the building.
That's why he took the facade off the roof last year, because that was falling out.
So it should be fenced then.
It should be fenced in, really.
Oh. Can you find out, Mr. Theodos, if that's what block and lot that's in, whether that implicates Green Acres and what we need to do to demolish it? I know, but let's
make sure.
So let him put that in writing first. Let him find that out and put it in writing and make sure that's the case. And then
also, if they have electric to that building, it'd be probably a good idea to put a pole there and save that electric, because if you have an affair over there, you can run the electric.
There's no electric there, because we have
no electric
there. The farmer's market, they had a new generator and stuff, right?
That service has been taken down, I can tell you. It's just a mess to get up the wire to the new room to run it.
You do have an electric in that closet. Yeah, that's it. Underground. It's an underground thing down the gazebo.
All right, the other business that we need to discuss is the attorney for the Miller property. We have not had any contact to ascertain what direction, what's the direction that the current attorney is going.